before the country code when placing satellite calls.
In the United States, Ron has artifacts and information on display from his fieldwork. For example, from Sodom and Gomorrah is this burnt spearhead and this burnt bone. From the Red Sea crossing site is a horse's hoof. And from Jerusalem are items found at the crucifixion site. We also met up with some of Ron's close associates.
Oh no.
Hey!
Maybe wait in the car.
That's what I thought.
You wanted to sign over something from a few days ago. Are you videotaping this?
I am, yeah.
Okay, good. Okay, what this is it's a stalactite, which is approximately 11 to 12 inches long. This was the stalactite that was hanging down in front of the chamber, or the entrance into the chamber where Ron first entered and found the Ark of the Covenant. And he broke it off, and you can see where it's broken right here. If you can get that in the proper light, you can see where it's broken off. He broke that off so that the little Arab boy that was with him could get into the chamber. Of course, I believe later, if I remember the story correctly, he had to enlarge the hole a little bit so he could get in. But this is the stalactite from that cave.
Tell us what this is.
Let me put this away. The seal stone that was in the cross hole that we believe held the cross of Christ. And they used these seal stones to plug the hole when it wasn't being used, so that in between uses, it wouldn't fill up with debris and everything, because then you couldn't get anything in it. And in a 12-inch square hole would be very difficult to dig the debris and everything out. It was approximately about two and a half feet deep. I think it was 28 inches, something like that.
Do you know which way up it went? Was it this way up, or
this way up? I believe it was like this. The reason I say that is because you can see the seepage here. It's kind of a concretion where it was sitting like this, and the moisture formed on the bottom.
Okay.
But that's just a speculation on my part. I believe it was
that
like this.
Okay.
And it's approximately 12 inches by 13 inches. It's not quite square. It's a little bit longer this way than it is that way.
And that fit securely in the hole, so that the
cross... In fact, on the video, you can see it sitting in the hole.
Okay.
I believe in one of the video shots.
So the upright beam for the cross, that's about the rough dimensions it would have been.
Would have been approximately, probably about 12 by 12.
Okay.
Ron's work in Turkey led to government recognition of the site of Noah's Ark. Ron has some significant artifacts from this site.
This is deck timber. It was taken from near the back of Noah's Ark. Ron found this on the radar scan, and they dug it up. It's been tested. It contains organic carbon, which is consistent with what you find with petrified wood. Now, one of the unique things about this, if we can get it in the light just right, this is actually a piece of deck board that's been laminated. There are three separate layers. You can see one right here. It's a larger center section, and it's a little darker in color. And then a bottom section here, three different layers. This area right here appears to be a silica replacement of the glue that was used to glue these boards or laminate these boards together. Some of it has seeped out the side. Now, another interesting feature of this deck board is nails.
Oh, okay.
Nail heads. Or there's one right here. Let me get it into the light and see it a little bit better. And you can experiment with your camera angle. There's one here. Okay. Nail heads. Or, there's one right here. Let me get it into the light and see it a little bit better. And you can experiment with your camera. There's one here. There's one, two, three in a row right here.
Marty Plott also has a section of fossilized wood from Noah's Ark.
So Ron gave you this?
Yeah.
This is from Noah's Ark.
It is from Noah's Ark.
My shoes in the car. Okay.
That's kind of an old boat, probably the oldest on the planet.
Ron also has some ancient human bones of gigantic proportions.
This first one is a human thumb bone. And it's been identified by radiologists as the second bone of the thumb, this bone right here.
The Bible records that giants existed in ancient times.
As you can see, it's approximately 2.5 times the size of mine, which if you can extrapolate from that, this person was probably somewhere between 11 to 12 feet tall. That this bone belonged to. Now, the bone of a child, the epiphysis is still visible here. That's what you find on a bone that has not completely grown. You find this in children. And as you can see, as I hold it up here, it's just a little bit larger than mine, but mine is full grown. So this was a rather large child. Now this third specimen, unlike the other two, is petrified. And this was found near the Tower of Babel, and it has been identified as a human toe bone, probably from the big toe. And as you can see, it's quite large, bigger than any toe. This would just be one of two bones in the toe, so we're talking about a toe that's probably 6 to 7 inches long.
It was a big toe.
That was somebody with a very big foot.
From Noah's Ark, Ron retrieved a metal alloy rivet.
What this is a rivet that was found in association with Noah's Ark. What's two remarkable things is you can see the edge of the plate right here where it ends. And you can also see part of the head of the rivet, and where, as Ron says, it was struck while it was hot, and the hot metal flared out and made it larger than the hole so it wouldn't slide back through plate. When I was over there in June of 97, Andrew Jones and I found and photographed a whole plate with two rivets in it that had rust stains all around them. You know, we have that on both photograph and video. And these things are real, and they look very, very similar to this. This is a very distinct separation here. Mm-hmm. In fact, I imagine you would still see if you chip some of this matrix material off. But you see it's broken. And here's some broken pieces of it right here, see? Mm-hmm. But we won't attempt to remove those. It looks very fragile, so please don't.
We were with him when he found the trash over.
Oh, that's right. You were on that trip, weren't you?
I had that on video at the spot.
Ron had survived imprisonment and even a kidnapping at gunpoint during his explorations, but poor health finally caught up with him. Ron had planned to dive with us at the Red Sea and regretted having to cancel his trip.
I was sorry that I couldn't go diving with you guys because, but I couldn't. Apologizing for things that are out of my control, because there's obviously some reason for it.
Ron had been battling with cancer for some time. Sadly, in the early hours of the 4th of August, 1999, Ron passed away and is now resting in the Lord. But his work lives